Thank you for tuning into our seller interview series. Up today, we've got an AdSense and advertising 27-site package for sale in the gaming niche. Created in November 2003, this business makes $3,560 per month in net profit, and the listing number for the business is 45107. We do these interviews to give potential buyers more information about both the seller and the businesses they're looking to purchase. We hope these insights are helpful for you in making a buying decision. We've got the seller with us today to go through the business and cover everything from niche selection to traffic and monetization. Jason, thank you for coming on here today. How are you doing?
Good, Jake. Thank you. I'm fine.
Well, I'm very excited to have you on here and to hear about your experience, you know, with AdSense and advertising sites. You know, it can be a very lucrative business model, but also not requiring a ton of time. I'm very excited to get your take on it. But before we dive into the questions that I have for you, I want to go ahead and run through a little quick summary of the business. Again, the business was built in 2003, has a monthly revenue of $4,180, expenses of $620 to make for a net profit of $3,560, which is generated on a nine-month average. Included in the sale of this business are 27 domains and all site content and files, plus six additional domains, all social media, SOPs for adding games to network, SOPs for backlink building. Please note that you must currently have an approved AdSense account before purchasing this business to assure a successful migration of the business. Jason, can you tell us a little bit about your background in building and running online businesses?
Yeah, so originally I started with offline retail businesses, selling different products on the retail side, but you know, learned that there was just so much overhead and dealing with employees. And so I started getting into internet marketing and I moved into online e-commerce and had some success there. And then so I decided to reinvest in purchasing existing online websites in order to, you know, maintain and grow them and improve them, and then hopefully either keep them for the long term or resell them at a later date after they had grown.
So are you insinuating then that you didn't start these, you purchased these and are now flipping them?
That's correct. Yes, I did purchase this network of sites and, you know, I saw a great opportunity to generate some passive income from them and get a better return on my investment than, you know, you would in an offline type of investment. And so far, you know, the return has been what I expected. And now, you know, I'm looking to give this network an opportunity to grow with someone that can take it further than I can.
When did you purchase the sites?
I purchased them in May of 2018.
So that, you know, we're looking at about 6 months. In the past 6 months, what have you seen in terms of growth for the business?
So what I've seen is that there are several different gaming developers and other sites in the similar niche that really want to partner up and interact and share, whether it be games to the communities or links. So I think there's not just opportunities to put games out there for the visitors, but there's definitely opportunities to generate, you know, advertising revenues around, you know, advertising exclusively with some of these game providers as well.
So how does this business in particular make money?
So it makes money when visitors come to play games on the site through AdSense, so clicks on the AdSense banner ads. It also has several advertising relationships where there is a cost per click methods. There are CPMs, so CPM impressions with some of the larger ad networks, and these are in the form of banner ads, homepage takeovers, and floor ads for some major global brands.
And then you mentioned that these businesses, these sites are very passive to run. So define what that means to you. How much time do you need to invest?
Yeah, so today what I mainly spend my time doing is just occasionally adding new games to the sites and, you know, switching up the top games that visitors see when they first get to the homepage of the sites. And it's very easy to do. It's one content management page, and it'll update all of the sites at the same time. And you could actually schedule the postings in advance. So sometimes I will just spend maybe 2 to 3 hours in a week, and I'll set it up to continually post games each day for the next few weeks just to keep things fresh. And there's really no maintenance required on the sites, no design changes, alterations, no coding knowledge needed. They really stand alone and operate very efficiently on their own.
So how do the sites relate to each other?
So the main difference is that, the main similarities in how they relate is that they have very same look and feel and navigation. The main difference is that each specific site has the URL of a specific country, and games are in the language, and the game descriptions are also in the language of that particular country to target visitors for that particular country, which creates a great opportunity to focus more on a country or region specific basis and generate more revenue for the entire network.
So what about the businesses today has led you to believe that now is the time to sell?
Well, one of the main reasons why I am selling is because I have invested in some other websites since I purchased this, and that's really starting to take off a completely different industry, the employment and more product related industries. But now I feel as though, one, timing, even at this time of year where we're getting into the holiday season, advertisers are going to be spending a lot more on the bidding. So that is generally going to generate higher revenues, but also simply because, you know, there are always opportunities to get into, you know, a industry like this with the online gaming. I feel like more and more people are coming on the internet each and every day for the first time, and more children, and are also looking for ways to play online games. And so, you know, this is a great opportunity for someone to get in and really capitalize on some countries that really have not even, you know, their particular websites haven't been, you know, they've been less focused on, and there can be more development and more opportunities into driving traffic on those particular sites.
What are you going to miss about owning these sites?
I think the thing I'll miss the most is just having a large network like this and just being able to know that, you know, that they add value to, you know, young children, teens, and even regular adults that still like playing these types of games online. Most of them are more recreational games, but there are a couple of sites on the network that really focus on educational games. So, you know, the fact that you're adding value and knowing that even some schools access those particular sites to help educate children is really something I'll miss, and hope that a buyer takes pride in knowing that they're adding value in that way.
When looking at all of the sites as a whole, I recognize that it's really a site is focused on a different territory and country, so has a different language behind it. But does one site outperform all of them, or the 27 sites come together to make up that $3,500 every single month in profit?
Yeah, so there is, out of those 27 sites, there I would say there is a top five that perform really well and generate probably more than 50% of the revenue in a month. And that stems from being back in 2003 when the network was started. Those were some of the very first sites that were established. And so they're well known in their particular countries and receive a lot of returning visitors.
So with the business being really passive as it is, what do you feel are some of the major opportunities for growth?
I think that maybe considering doing different forms of traffic, like a pay-per-click campaign, or like I mentioned before, maybe going to a gaming company or a company that caters to young folks, like in a toy company, and selling direct ad space. Another opportunity would be maybe looking into video ad companies and doing some more video pre-roll advertising. So, you know, kind of like video previews, if you're watching on YouTube, you can have video ads play while games are loading. Sometimes the games take, you know, 3-5 seconds to load in the background. This could certainly add another source of ad revenue that actually hasn't been tapped into across the network.
You mentioned adding other traffic sources. So what is the greatest traffic source for all of these sites?
Mainly, I think one of the best opportunities and something that I definitely would recommend is taking advantage of social media. There are several social media accounts specifically geared towards the different regions that will be included for the buyer. And, you know, one thing that I would recommend is if you are going to add new games, is to also promote and post those new games announcements on social media like Facebook and Twitter, and then also grow those followings as well. And by doing so, you know, I think that will generate a lot more interest and get a lot of new traffic. Also, there is, you know, paid traffic for redirects and pop-ups. And I found that has also provided some initial bumps in traffic, but also in monitoring that, it's provided for the returning visitors to come back. And that's helped the revenue and stable things out over the last 6 months that I've had the sites.
You've owned a lot of sites and a lot of online businesses. As you said, that's kind of what you try to do, buy, grow, and flip businesses. So how do you feel that you've grown as an entrepreneur by owning these sites in particular?
So one of the reasons why I'm definitely in the buying of existing site space is because I know where my weaknesses are. And while I'm developing those in terms of being able to build sites from scratch and, you know, create valuable content, you know, I find that getting this established business, I've learned a lot more on the technical side and being able to understand how these sites actually function. And I've also learned a lot more just about understanding analytics and traffic volumes and how to actually, you know, look for ways to monetize this. So I didn't know anything about, you know, this particular niche before getting into it. But, you know, I've definitely learned that in order to be successful, that you really have to go out there and communicate with some of the gaming developers, keep looking for games that are available online that allow you to post to your particular site, and then just, you know, being a, you know, a good person that is able to, you know, maintain the traffic as well.
Do you feel like there are any potential risks associated with owning these sites that a new owner should be aware of?
I think, you know, kind of just letting them sit there and not doing anything, like losing regular daily visitors by not adding the occasional new content, is, you could risk people looking for new games elsewhere, but I don't think there are risks in the way of people not playing online games. I think in many of these countries, lots of kids play the online games or mobile games from sites. So this network, again, it's well known and established, you know, for the past 15 years. And so the advertising relationships that are built up are very strong and stable. So I think that there is going to be, one, a limited risk in the demand for online gaming, but I also think that there are going to be increased opportunities to focus in on certain countries that are less aware that those particular online games are actually available.
So looking back over the course of owning this business, and now here you are today, you know, you've decided to sell these sites so you could focus on something else. But historically, when you would look at a business like this, how do you decide when it's the right time to sell it?
So one of the things I look for, sometimes deciding the right time to sell it, is if I feel as though I have reached my limits with time to be able to devote to it accordingly, and or sometimes if there is another opportunity that I really want to focus in on that wasn't there previously, you know, I will make sure that the business that I've already invested in doesn't miss out on an opportunity to continue growing, especially if I'm going to give it the lack of focus and time. And so, you know, what I do there is I decide, well, you know, things are going well, things are stable, I've developed a good process and procedures for managing it. And sometimes I will rewrite those from what they were when I previously acquired the business to make them more efficient. And then this way, knowing that if a new buyer doesn't have the time or wants to outsource or, you know, hire somebody to do this, then, you know, they can basically have all of those instructions and all of those tutorials. And that just comes from, I've made purchases in the past where when I didn't do enough due diligence, you know, I realized after the purchase was completed, I had more questions that unfortunately, you know, the seller did not answer. And it left me in a position where, you know, I couldn't manage it as to my full potential. So one of my most important goals is to make sure that any new owner or any business that I sell is always going to be in a position to be successful.
What do you like about the AdSense model as compared to other online business models?
I do like that it's fairly straightforward and pretty easy, you know, to create ads and you work with Google AdSense. You know, I think that for me, the earnings are pretty predictable and pretty stable as well. And so I know with getting the right amount of traffic, how I can increase those earnings, where, you know, some of the other models, they have, every model has its advantages and disadvantages, but I think some of the models can be less predictable or, you know, newer in a sense in terms of, you know, how long that they've been around versus Google AdSense. So I still have a good strong trust and faith in the Google AdSense model. And it's certainly been successful here on this network and with other businesses that I've owned.
What advice would you have for someone who wants to get started with their own AdSense business?
You know, I would say the most important thing is to, you know, just get started in building great content online. And don't focus on how your site is going to look like, you know, what it's going to look like, making worried about the design. I mean, there are some, you know, general requirements that you must have. But if you spend too much time planning, I've learned that you never really get anything done. So just build valuable content and don't focus on how much you can earn or what you want to earn. You want to make sure that you add value and get content because you're going to need that traffic to come to that site before you can focus on getting the conversions and getting the clicks. So, you know, just focus on adding value, finding the niche that works for you, and doing that research that you need to do in order to be successful.
How does owning online businesses compare to the other jobs that you've had in the past?
So one thing that's definitely been different is the time. And, you know, I still have a full-time career and it does take up a lot of time, you know, maybe 40 to 50 hours a week in the office and commuting. And yet my online businesses, I actually earn more than that full-time job. But yet I spend probably close to 15 to 20% of that same amount of time. So maybe 10 hours a week in my online businesses. And people will ask me, well, why haven't I made the change and gone full-time? Because I don't think it's a perfect ratio. I don't think that if I spent 50 hours a week on my businesses that I would see that same X number of growth potential. You know, I do think that having multiple streams of income is valuable. And so even though, you know, a full-time career right now takes up some time, I do think that the online business space is just something that, you know, is passionate. I kind of just challenged myself to see how much I can grow things. And I always just like having that safety net and, you know, having the extra benefits for the family, you know, certainly helps too when you have an offline job as well.
Hey, Jason, thank you so much for the time today. I really appreciate it. My final question for you is, given all of your extensive experience with owning online businesses, running online businesses, what about this particular network of sites makes it a business worth buying?
So I think the really unique thing is that it's not just one single website focused on one particular traffic in one particular region. You really can target and focus in on different countries, different regions, and it really has, you know, plenty of content where you really don't need to add any more content. It's probably, you know, as passive as you can get. Yes, there's, if you put in the work, you will see the reward. But if someone is looking to generate revenue on day one and have something that has been around for a very long time, then this is definitely the network for them.
Jason, thank you again so very much for your time today. I really appreciate you coming on here, talking about this business, and sharing some of your insights with us.
Absolutely. Thank you, Jake.
If you're watching this on YouTube, subscribe to our channel. And if you want more information, the link will be below the video that will take you to this marketplace listing. If you're watching this on the listing site and want more information, become a depositor today. When you make the deposit, one of our business advisors will be in contact with you, and you will be given everything you need to review this business. Have a great day.